We're just now getting into the second half of October, and I don't really have a deer that I've got kind of pegged down that I'm really hunting, so I'm just going to kind of bounce around between some of my kind of pre-rut spots, like areas that have a lot of does and areas that, you know, generally seem to just kind of have the transient bucks that pass through, like little funnels and stuff, and spots where the first scrapes really start getting hammered. These bucks are going to be out cruising, checking does here shortly, just kind of making their rounds and establishing their area for where they want to be during the rut. And so I'll have some spots kind of have bucks start showing up. So I'm just going to kind of bounce around between them. And honestly, you know, it's kind of, sometimes it's more fun not having a deer that I'm just after and stressing out about and wondering what he's doing, and just get out and kind of hunt. Well, that was a pretty cool hunt. Saw seven does, big old half rack coming and terrorized them. The spot where I just went and moved that stand on my lunch break today, that big old giant split brow buck showed up like maybe at the last possible second of shooting light or something like that. But that's a good sign. I was worried it'd be kind of too much commotion for him, but he showed up. It's this humongous steep cliff, and then these people's yard's flat, and there's about 75 yards of woods that's flat, and man, every year it'd be scraped all down that little flat part of the woods, and it kind of connects two bigger blocks of woods. It's just a spot that, man, it's like I may have 7 to 10 different mature bucks daylight on this little 7 acres at some point between now and like middle of November. So it's just one of them spots, man, with a cold front hitting. If something was to get out and start rolling around, I definitely could get a chance at them. I'm excited. I'm gonna get changed and ease out here and just see what happens.
Set up, wind's perfect. I was trying to set my stand up in here. I already had sticks here. I went to set my stand up and dropped it and bent my little bow holder thing, but it's still holding it, so it's just a weird angle. It's a good thing the wind's perfect because the sun is just beating down on me. Can't help but sweat.
Well, that was freaking awesome. Passed a good 10 pointer. Probably would have shot if I hadn't had some of them bigger, that bigger buck on camera last night. And anyway, I look over and I see this bigger buck standing there, probably 30, 35 yards, and it's just kind of dark to shoot that far. But man, he snort wheezes a little bit, then that 10 just snort wheezes like a full blown one. And a little while later, he does a full blown one. They end up fighting underneath me after dark, it sounded like, and just an awesome hunt, man. Watched a nice 8-pointer make a rub. Literally, aside from killing, that was about as cool of a hunt as you're ever gonna have. I waited like an hour after dark and started howled like a coyote and got down. But man, that was cool.